Hey guys, and welcome back to another Minecraft mod showcase. Today we'll be reviewing the Torch Lever mod. I'm gonna go into game mode 0, or survival mode. And this gun and this armor, like this stuff, it's not part of the Torch Levers mod, so it's part of a Secret Agents mod, so I'm not gonna review that. I'm also not gonna review those grenades in the left corner, because that's not part of this mod. I'm gonna do those in later mods. I actually already reviewed those grenades and where they're from. I think it's raining. Okay, toggle down fall. Alright. So, let's turn it to peaceful, actually. I am going to need to turn it to something else later, but yeah. This is the Torch Levers mod. It's a really cool mod that adds a whole bunch of hidden traps and like all these things to your game. And let's start off with a lot of the traps. First of all, there are the spikes, which they are triggered by redstone. I'll get into the crafting recipes later. So there's all sorts of different spikes, and see, they all do damage and they have special effects. This one, the normal spikes do normal damage. Flaming spikes set you on fire. The slowing spikes, I believe, slow you. Yes, slow you. These spikes blind you. I don't want to get blinded, though. These spikes poison you. These spikes wither you. And these ones do not get triggered by redstone. They're automatic. So, yeah. So they can all be triggered by redstone, except for the last one, which is automatic. There's also a bunch of new redstone things, which is, like this button, it can be pressed super fast, and this redstone lever, I don't know what the difference is. And there's also, for some reason, they don't get a redstone signal from behind, they don't send one from behind, I don't know why. And now there's also the redstone torch buttons. They work like a redstone torch, as in, they give a redstone signal, but from behind, when you can press it, and you can tell it's a button by that, but it's supposed to be pretty hidden. There's also the torch button, and then there's the redstone torch lever, and the torch lever. And those are really cool additions to this mod, because it's really hidden. Now, there's also the carpet trapdoors, which I'm gonna turn back into game mode 1. But they're basically trapdoors hidden, so you can, like, randomly, you don't know where you hide it, but they're carpet trapdoors. And, here we got something actually to show. Actually, yeah, this actually involves something else. But here you can craft nether brick buttons, and book buttons. Basically, you can right click there with it, and you can just have sort of hidden buttons in your system. So in your house, if you have a big library, one of them can have a button, and they'll trigger a redstone signal or something. You can do that with bricks and nether bricks as well. And yeah. Now there are also illusion blocks. Basically, they're blocks that aren't even there. They just disappear like that. And yeah, basically you can just walk through. And now we're gonna come over here. And if there is no block under the carpet trap doors and you sprint on it, there's not gonna be any footprints. But if there is something like ladders under it, you're going to see, like, let me just try to sprint. You'll see the ladder footprints. So basically, if you can tell where a trapdoor is, another use for the illusion blocks. So, for example, because under these are sandstone, you can put an illusion block sandstone there, and then basically you can just hop right through, store all your valuables, and nobody can tell by looking at the footprints. Now here we also have the collapsing quartz. When you drop an item, you'll sort of do that, and yeah, you can sort of make traps like that. It also happens if mobs other than the player happen to stand on it. Let's get a peaceful mob, like a squid. Oh yeah, well, if any entity or item just goes on it, it'll fall, drop feathers, and yeah. And, yeah. Also, one last thing over here, we have the hinged paintings, and basically these paintings work as doors, and you can place them on illusion blocks, so you can do that, and you can also just place them just on the floor and just open and close them, and yeah, basically you can think it's a normal wall, but it's not. You can just go through, and yeah, it's basically it for what these things can do. It's really, I just sort of did a brief summary of it, but let's get to the crafting recipes. First, for the collapsing oak slabs, you can do it with any slab, actually. And all you get is the normal slab and the feather, and you'll get the collapsing slabs. You can get them for any single slab in the game. Next is the carpet trapdoors. You can do this with any carpet. Just get that color carpet and a trapdoor. And for the illusion blocks, you just get whatever block you want and an eye of ender, and you'll get that illusion block. You can see there's a bunch of illusion blocks. For the redstone button, you just surround a button by redstone, a wooden or stone button by redstone, you'll get it. And for the redstone torch button, you get a redstone torch with a button or a wooden button. For the torch button, same thing, but with a normal torch. The redstone lever, you either get a block redstone with a stick or a normal lever surrounded by redstone. You can, for torch lever, you either get coal, a stick, and cobblestone like this to get a torch lever, or charcoal, and you can just add charcoal or coal to a normal torch. And the same thing with redstone, except with a normal lever. And, yeah, you add, redstone to a normal lever. Now for these buttons, you can get the brick button. All you do is combine them with, either a wooden or stone button. And for spikes, you get iron, like this, stone, and a piston, and you can get two spike traps, which are then combined with either slime balls, fermented spider eyes, wither skeleton skulls, rotten flesh, blaze powder, and pressure plate to get all of these spikes, like the automatic spike trap. And for the hinged painting, you just combined a painting with the trap door. So yeah, that's pretty much it for this mod. There's a whole bunch of things you can do with it. For example, just like put illusion blocks, and then there's automatic spikes right under, and you can just like die. What I think they should add is though automatic special spikes, like the automatic sort of these spikes, automatic sling spikes, automatic blinding spikes, and you know, so on. Basically, that'd be cool if they added that. But yeah, I sort of made a brief overview of it, but it's a really cool mod. Actually, it has a lot of potential. It already is really famous, and I think if I ever do a modded survival series or get a mod pack sort of thing, I would include this in it because it's really helpful, good for hiding your valuables, and good for traps and all that stuff. Even though there are mods that are specifically for traps, this is pretty good. So yeah, I really like this mod. But yeah, guys, that's pretty much it for this mod today. Yeah, and I'll see you guys all later.